My name is Aloysius Christopher Parker, and if I ever have a son, he'll be Charles Christopher Parker, just like Charlie Parker. But people I know just call me Allie, and this is my story, or part of it. I don't expect it to explain all that much, but what's a story anyway except one of those connect-the-dots drawings that in the end forms a picture of something? That's really all this is. That's how things work for me. I go from this place, this person, to that place or person. And, you know, doesn't really make that much difference. I've known all different kinds of people. I've hung out with them, lived with them, watched them act things out in their own little ways. And to me, those people I've known are like a series of rooms. Just like all the places where I've spent time. You walk in for the first time curious about this new room. Lamp, TV, whatever. And then after a while, the newness is gone completely. And then there's this kind of dread, kind of creeping dread. You probably don't even know what I'm talking about. But anyway. I guess the point of all this is that after a while, something tells you, some voice speaks to you, and that's it. Time to split. Go someplace else. People are going to be basically the same, maybe use some different kind of refrigerator or toilet or something. But this thing tells you, and you have to start the drift. You may not even want to go, but things will inform you. So here I am now in a place where I don't even understand their language. But, you know, strangers are still always just strangers. And the story, this part of the story, well, it's how I got from there to here. Or maybe I should say from here to here.
Since Thursday.
Walking. Just walking around. I can't seem to sleep at night. Not in this city.
Sleep at all.
Well, I have my dreams while I'm awake.
Thank you.
You know, sometimes I think I should just live fast and die young. And go in a three-piece white suit like Charlie Parker. Not bad, huh? She has dropped a roll of paper from her breast. A stranger picks it up, shuts himself in his room all night, and reads the manuscript, which contains the following. When she ventured out with her silk net on the end of a rush chasing the wild, free hummingbird. Send me one, and I in return will wreath a garland of violets, mint, and geraniums. I was not present at the event of which my daughter's death was the result. If I had been, I would have defended that angel at the cost of my blood. Maldoror was passing with his bulldog. He sees a young girl sleeping in the shade of a plane tree. At first, he took her for a rose. It is impossible to say which came first to his mind, the sight of this young girl or the resolution which followed. He undresses rapidly like a man who knows what he is going to do. He opens the angular claws of this steel hydra, and armed with a scalpel of the same kind, seeing that the green of the grass had not yet disappeared beneath all the blood which had been shed, he prepares without blending to dig his knife courageously into the unfortunate child's widened hole. He pulls out one after one. Corpses sleep again in the shade. Pig snouted. Brutishness covered him with its protective wings and cast loving glances at him. I'm tired of this book. You can have it.
Finished with it. I'm tired of being alone.
Everyone is alone. That's why I just drift, you know. People think it's crazy. But it's better to think that you're not alone, you know, when you're drifting, even though you are. Instead of just knowing that you're alone all the time. Some people, you know, they can distract themselves with ambitions and the motivation to work, you know, but it's not for me. They think people like myself are crazy, you know. Everyone does. Because of the way I live, you know. I don't know. I guess you can say it's reckless. But it's the only way for me, you know. My mother was like those kind of people telling me it's bad to be like that. And she ended up crazy herself, you know, after my father was gone. But I don't care anymore, you know, I don't want to think about it. I know that when I get the feeling, you know, the drift is gonna take me. Feeling inside my head that's been haunting me for a long time. Up until now, because I've decided to go visit someone I haven't seen in a long time. I'm gonna go back and see my mother. I haven't seen her in over a year. She's in an institution. But first, I'm gonna go back to where I was born, the building that my mother and father lived in. Was blown up during the war. I'm gonna walk through the rubble there and just look at it one more time. Look at how the building is all bombed out. Walk through the rubble of the building where I was born.
What are you talking about? What war?
The building was blown up during the war.
Blown up by who?
The Chinese.
Thank you.
incoming rounds!
Yeah, what's the matter?
Hey, it doesn't matter, you plane! Get on the ground!
Take it easy, man.
So not even planes, there are choppers. The Kong doesn't have choppers. Come on, man. Take it easy. Get up. You see? Those are American. A cigarette? Yeah. Hey, want to hear a funny story? The other day, I was walking over by where I used to live, you know, a long time ago. Right in front of my house was this big car, really shiny, you know, one of these old cars, like two-tone, and very shiny car, lots of chrome, you know. Really beautiful, like a bubble car, very big and round, you know. That was the most beautiful car I ever saw. I wanted a car just like it, you know. It was really bad. And then today, you know, I woke up and I couldn't believe it. I walked out of my house where I live now, and the same car I saw, the same exact car. Wow, I really flipped, man. It lit up like a bomb, this car, you know. It was so great. Really like a Batmobile. Like a gangster car. Just like that. It was bad. So what do you say to that?
I live back there.
Oh, yeah? Someplace to live. You should get out of here, man. You should get away from here. Go someplace different. That's what I'm gonna do. Take it easy.
I'm gonna get out of here too.
Christopher Barker. It's me, your son. Mom, it's me, Allie. I'm here to see you.
My son is here to see me.
How are you? Have you been all right? Do you feel all right here?
I know who you were. I know you were my son. I knew because those eyes aren't yours and they don't belong to you. They were taken out of your father's head. Sometimes I haven't heard them since the war when we were bombed. Is there another war going on?
Excuse me, ladies. It's time for your medication. And would you mind leaving the room for a few moments and then you can come right back?
Por ahí a pasear, a buscarla donde anda moliendo la caña de azúcar del cañaveral. ¡Ay, ay, 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 ay! Canta y no lloren, porque cantando se arreglan, cielito lindo, los corazones. ¡Cállense, que la reina te va a oír! ¡Cállense!
Are you all right?
What are you singing?
Can I not get it?
What?
Go! Get out of here!
Well, I just wanted to know what you were saying.
I'd like to buy some popcorn.
75 cents?
Do you think I would like this movie?
The Queen, the Eskimo film? Well, the only parts that I remember were the first part where they're eating maggots, and the second part where the old lady tells the pregnant daughter that the firstborn, if it's a boy, they rub it with blubber for good luck, and the second, if it's a girl, they stuff snow in its mouth and kill it.
He's stopping. He's gonna dump it. You ever heard of the Doppler effect? Doppler effect.
Yeah, I heard of it. Yeah, sure. Oh no, it's when sound changes when it moves.
Oh yeah, that's a Doppler effect. Yeah, that's the name of my joke. The Doppler effect. The Doppler effect. You see, back in the '50s, there's this guy. He played the sax. He played a mean sax too. Yeah. But he was out of his time. His sound was different, way out, too advanced with all those folks. But he couldn't get no work because he didn't want to conform to the traditional style of playing. So times was rough for him. So his friends got together and they said, "Look, man, you ought to go on over to Europe. See over there, they play a different sound. You know, you fit in. You be able to play." And they got together some money and bought him a ticket to Paris. So he goes over there, and when he gets over there, the same old thing. His sound's too advanced for them. Nobody know where he's coming from. And he couldn't get no job playing because he still didn't want to conform to the traditional style of playing at the time. So he gets real depressed, gets upset. And he's broke, he ain't got no money, so he's got to go out in the street and start playing. He plays out there and he gets into junk and all kinds of stuff, and it's just too much for him. He's not making it. So one day he decides to climb up some stairs and go up on a roof and jump off and end it all. He up there and it's a gray day. Everything's gray, the skies are all gray. And he's looking down, and he looked up, and just as he was about ready to jump, the skies open up, and there's this ray of light hit him like a spotlight. And for no reason at all, he picked up his horn and started playing somewhere over the rainbow. Da 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 da. And as far as he got, he couldn't remember no more. He just kept on playing that same verse over and over and over again. But he couldn't remember no further. Just couldn't. Then all of a sudden, people all down gathered around, started looking up at him, and police come up to the roof and sneaking up on him from the back. And he's still trying to remember the next verse. He turned around and looked, see the police coming, and he jumps down. Yeah, there he is down there. He ain't died from the fall. And he was conscious, and he heard in the distance the sound of the ambulance coming. And, he was going da 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 da.
What do you want to hear, kid?
I don't care as long as it's vibrating, bugged out sound. Man, what a sax.
Thank you. this gun. This gun is my legislative gun. No, I get it now. It's this gun is my legislative branch. No, that's it. That's it.
Thank you.
Well?
I'll give you $800 for it.
$800? It's worth more than that. I could get more than that for it.
Go ahead.
$800 is all you can give me? I need the money, okay. Okay.
You going on the boat too?
No, I just got here.
Where are you from?
I'm from France, in Paris.
You born there?
Yeah, I was born there. Were you born in New York?
Yeah, but I'm leaving.
Yeah, I had to leave too.
How come?
See, I have a lot of trouble there. That's why I have to get out of Paris. And now my friends are crying. You see, I never cry. Because I know things change, I have to go somewhere. And now I think that New York is going to be Babylon for me. Because that's where I got to live.
You think I would like it in Paris?
Yeah, Paris is going to be a Babylon.
Yeah. I just got a tattoo the other day.
Oh yeah?
I kind of wanted to get one before I went away.
I got a tattoo here since a year.
What's it say?
It means mommy. Oh, you got a diamond shape? Pretty good.
I gotta go. My boat.
I gotta go.
I was thinking about the note I left her when I got on the boat. But how can you explain something like this to someone? I'm just not the kind of person that settles into anything. I don't think I ever will be. There isn't really anything left to explain that can be, and that's what I was trying to explain in the first place. Just not like that. I don't want a job or a house or taxes, although I wouldn't mind a car, but I don't know. Now that I'm away, I wish I was back there more than even when I was there. Let's just say I'm a certain kind of tourist. Tourist that's on a permanent vacation.